Hello, and welcome everyone to part 5 of the Hun Let's Play for Total War Attila. We continue where we left off last time, and you guys smashed the like target that I set in part 4 to get an hour special for part 5. You guys actually got 2,000 likes. Now, I know some of you have been saying, can we please have a 2-hour special, but I'm afraid I don't have time to do a 2-hour special today, so it will just be the 1-hour special. But you will be getting another hour special soon at part 10, and maybe then, yes, in the future, I will set higher like targets, which will result in 2-hour specials. We'll see. Anyway, thank you again for your War Council advice. I've had pretty much two conflicting major bits of advice. One was to continue pushing west, subjugating the factions that have lands. And I know I need to subjugate now, guys. Shame I picked that up a bit too late. But yeah, I know I need to subjugate my enemies where I can. So it was pushing west and then hitting, hopefully, some weakened Eastern Roman Empire lands down here that have already probably been hit by various hordes and what have you. The other was a suggestion, which a lot of you got behind, was fleeing east and taking out some of the hordes that we encounter and factions down here and then subjugating them under our banner, then we should have a lot of strength to then flow back west. I quite like that idea, but I'm not giving up on pushing west just yet. I think I've pulled out in various directions to attempt to draw my enemies in, and then I can turn on them and hit them. So I'm going to see if that works, and then if we can push west. But I might send one horde to the east, perhaps, to see if that'll work. Maybe these guys down here, the Steeds of Doom. We'll see if perhaps they can do. Now, also, a couple of you have been saying, why am I bothering to recruit infantry? I'm the Huns. Huns have full cav armies. That's well and good for them, but the armies I'm up against have a fair few spears. The reason why I've recruited spears is to lock in with their spear infantry and then flank and smash them in the back with cavalry. My cavs are still, you know, probably about 60-70% cav heavy. Okay, a couple of them have got some infantry archers, but that's what they started with anyway. I will go full on cav armies, but I think there's a time and a place for having some infantry in there as well, and the Huns do get access to some pretty cool infantry too. Also, I should say, I'm using a different mouse to the one I normally use, and I think its left and right mouse click buttons are a bit louder than the previous one I've used. Hopefully with the background in-game sound kind of mixed in, it won't sound too bad, but if it's absolutely awful, my apologies. I will switch back to my other mouse, but if you think this one's fine, let me know and I'll keep with it, because it's a bit more comfortable. Anyway,
yes.
We were going to try and harass these guys, or hinder them.
Sabotaging. I've seen it done.
It's been success. It's been successful. Now they can't hit us for one more turn, so that gives me one more turn to at least recruit another unit. It's going to have to be either horse archer or melee cav or infantry, but we've got enough infantry here. I'm going to go for another one of these mounted brigands. The Akat Ziri, or Ziri, yeah. Akat Ziri, I've been saying that as Akati, but that's completely wrong. Akat Ziri raiders. I would build another one of those, but they take two turns to build, and I doubt we're going to get a chance to harass them again. Also, I'm not going to go... These guys here, the Antians, I was going to go and hit their settlement here, but I'm not going to just yet, because... that would mean that they would then reinforce this army if I was at war with them. So I have to kind of hold out for another turn. But these guys are bearing down on me. But they can't reach me this turn, which is good. So it gives me another turn to potentially recruit some more units. So I've got plenty of horse archers. Let's get some more melee cav here. There we go. That's that whole army sorted out. I've got some infantry here. Again, it was just mainly to try and get cut down some of their spears. But obviously my cav will play a huge role here. They've been trying to hit me the Alans. So we'll see how that goes. Now this horde here, I was going to go and hit these guys. I assume if I start raiding here, it will actually... it will piss off the other hordes in the area, which includes these guys and this lot here, or rather the other armies. Let's have a look if it says anything. Local region. Well, I mean, no one holds this. It's a desolate region, so would that actually piss anyone off? Not that I need the extra money. The economy's doing quite well. The food's doing well. So let's just build up some more troops here. We're already going for two of the Shamans of the Eternal Sky. Excellent attack. against cavalry. Cool. We've got horse archers there. We've got more melee cav. But I'm going to go for, well, Shaman's Eternal Scar, the only melee cav I can get. So I'm going to go for it. Although we're already critting this. Oh, damn, they take two turns, actually. I was hoping I could finish things off here. We'll go for more horse archers, because... Oh, no. Oh, we can only recruit two per turn in this army. Okay. Okay, well, in that case, we won't queue up anything. We'll just wait. Is there anything we can upgrade in the hordes while we're here? Nope. Okay, so we're going to probably end turn. Need to force tributary states. The Gepids, thankfully, have remained our tributary states. So if we could punch through to them, then we could restore ourselves in their lands. We are deteriorating, though, which is not good.
There's a good pork roasting for you, and better ale and mead.
So eventually they're gonna turn against us, but we'll have to force them to fear us all. What are we researching? We're researching this felt maker. Cool. Okay, Munzuk's got a son here, Bleda, another son, and then a bastard daughter. Faction heir. It's okay. He's got no influence. Does your wife not help your influence? No. I've made tried to make him a grand spoiler, so it increases his. I know it's not doing anything, actually. I thought it might increase his influence per turn, but no, it's not. Okay, we're all fine there, so let's end it. Attila should be born next year. But apparently, some people have been saying that he doesn't actually show up as Munzuk's son. He shows up as a son of Uldin, my current faction leader. If that's the case, that kind of does suck. CA, please change that so that it's Munzuk. Well, I guess it's because, I don't know, because surely it's kind of a scripted event, so if you kill either, I don't know, actually. Maybe my faction leader can't die until war. After that time? Seriously? Now I'm screwed. Because they're going to come and attack me in my horde. Damn it. I should have attacked last turn. Okay, let's flee. The Vandals can't reinforce them. So we just fight them one-on-one now. That's okay. So we're going to go raid their settlement next time. Right. We apparently will win this, and I hope we do too. Let's jump on in and fight this battle. Let's do this. So yeah, just again, a heads up, if the mouse clicking is insanely annoying, my apologies. I will rectify this next time. I'm saying this because obviously in the battle it'll be click, 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 click. Yeah, we've got lots of melee cav. Plenty of infantry just to hold them. Oh, they've got it's a crossing as well. That's cool. What have we got over here? We've got some fields and a little hut. Nice rainy day. Oh, goody. Is there another crossing point? There is one over here. I'm going to send my melee cav all around that point to flank, along with my general. Actually, no, not with my general. Oh, and you guys have been asking, how do I group my men so that then they don't—they're not locked in formation. So when I first group them, this has changed between Rome 2 and Attila. But when you first group units, I'll show it with these horse archers here. So I press control. Well, you can press G, but I like to do control 2 or control 3 to group my units. Once I've selected that, instantly puts them into the right number. Because I might want to group some as group 4, group 3, or something like that. So that automatically groups them, but it puts them in a locked group formation. So to unlock them, you just hold down control and hit G, and the lock function goes, which means you can then do this. So I'm going to leave these guys here. Bows will be group 3. Bows stay here. Probably get hit by the slingers and what have you. And I've got Hunnic Spears. You're group 4, and you guys all need to just hold here. We'll put them close to the crossing in a moment. Probably shield all them as well, actually. There we go. And general here, because I need you to hold my infantry in place while I prepare to flank round. Ah, seriously? Damn it. Ah, it's actually quite capable AI. Balls. Okay, this is not going to work as I wanted it to. Off into the trees, try and hide. Off into the trees, try and hide. I'm actually going to retreat from the crossing because I can't hold them. Out of shield wall. Going to walk them. Archers here. The reason why I'm doing this, or why my thought process is this, is because if I hold them here, if I try and hold them here, they're supported with their spears on both sides. I needed to find a flank where their cavalry was not supported by spears. And that's what I was going to push around here and smash in the back. But with their spears split, I need to try and draw their forces to me to a kind of a common place. So they put their spears here, put their spears here. Then I can flank in behind with my cav. Obviously, I can hit these the Germanic axe band. That's not a problem. And obviously, I've split off my my horse archers. Just gotta watch that onager's not going to stop there and start firing. It is. So unfortunately, that's why I'm going to run my men. The fatigue system is faster in Attila to replenish than it was in Rome 2. These guys have all formed up here. They brought their slingers. Thankfully, all their slingers, well, majority of their slingers are here. They've got a couple of skirmishers over there. Should be able to take them out. Their general's also here. If they get rid of those spears and they don't spot my cavalry, particularly these ones, then I should be able to do some damage. I need them to go over here. Mounted warband. I'm going to have to go in with my cavalry here. You need to be on skirmish mode, guys. So I'm hitting my Hanic Spears. I'm going to charge in my general as well. Stop firing at will. Spears charge on in.
Our general is under attack.
Yeah, but he's going to be fine. He's going to be fine. And use his ability to break these guys quickly because I know I've got another unit of cav incoming. Right, we've supported him with these guys. Okay, we're actually going to leave them to run, try and run towards my cav here. Fire, 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 fire. Take him down, take him down, take him down. They've not seen my guys over there. These guys are now slowly moving down towards me. Or are they actually moving towards my my cav? Yep, they spotted some of my cav. Damn it. Right into the forest over here. More cav incoming. Spears over here. Help me out. Those guys have broken completely. Hit this next unit of Germanic Mounted Warband. Okay, right. For my plan to work, I'm going to have to just run these guys over here. I should have pulled them over earlier. We'll just hit these guys while we can. Oh, damn, they've hit my general. Not meant to happen. Run, general, run. Stop firing, just because I don't want to kill my general. Crossfire. Right, we're going to flank round these guys, and we're going to take out that onager. Flank them. Please attack, please attack, please attack.
Enemy units have been rallied.
Oh, right, yeah, you guys got me off skirmish mode. Sorry, forgot about that. Charge that onager. Horse archers, flank round. Broken these guys here. These guys are now free. Flank over here, you're probably really tired though. That's fine. And the fact that I've actually been able to leave some cavalry over here is good because these guys are then going to turn on me in a moment. That's okay. It'll work out. Did not go to plan, but that's okay. Right, you guys now charge these javelins. Skirmish down. Flank these guys. Sorry, cavalry, that I'm just running you like crazy. Sorry, not sorry. Form back up, general. In we go. Some nice cavalry charges. In come my lancers. That's it. Mow them all down. They're fleeing there. I think we've safely cleared that Onager crew. So that's good. That's 1,000 of them gone. Right, let's reform everything. Oh, damn, I accidentally put some horse archers in this army. Oh, I swear in this game, so far, I've really misgrouped a lot of things, actually. Right, infantry, reform your line. Archers, reform to here. I'm running you guys, I know, again, but right now, that is okay. Horse archers. Yeah, horse archers over here. Cavalry. Over here, but walking, because you guys are probably tired. No, you're okay. Yeah, it's not actually taking as much toll as I thought. Right, in that case, horse archers, you have one sole job, and that is to take down the Germanic nobles. They're medium infantry, so I'm going to put them on heavy shot. Oh, and I pulled this unit of cav out as well. Whoops. I've left one unit of melee cav over here. Hunnic warband, actually, that's okay. Unfortunately, I've run you guys here, so I'm going to have to get you to... Well, no, charge them. You might as well. You'll get a charge on these guys and break them before the spears get in there. So, while this is happening, you guys strike over here. You guys up over here. And let's see this charge. In you go, lancers. Nice. Cavalry strike into their belly because they've left all these guys completely exposed. Hunnic spears to here. General to here. Yeah, because my cavalry's getting hit hard by this lot. Damn, they've... Actually, you know what? You guys just keep skirmishing here. Horse archers, all of you. Heavy shot. Keep hitting here. Cavalry pull back here. Charge in here. Lancers pull back, because you're no good to me like that. And now, lancers... Lancers over here.
The men have broken and are
fleeing. Yeah, they've broken. That's okay, though. No, I've got to pull you guys back. I've got to pull you back, because these spears are coming. Mental warband, I need you guys breaking. Come on, you're wavering. Break before those... These guys come on in. Yeah, there you go. Right, pull back. Hit these guys. Hit these guys.
The enemy have rallied their units.
But thankfully, I'm with that unit on there on Scotchman, I'm just pulling those units away so they can't offer a full force against me.
Our men are, the enemy general is fallen.
Good. So let my spears go crazy there. Right, we broke those this lot over here. Right, go into these guys. They're exposed. Lancers up over this way. I know I'm running you again, but it's okay. I'm just let my archers tear them down. There we go. Normal shot. Take these guys out. General through here. Just make sure they're definitely dead. Right, flank on around behind them. Take these guys out. Lancers in here. Up in here. Up in here. Hunnic spears push up. And I'm running with you, but it's okay. Lanhut slowly getting used to not hopefully failing with his cavalry all the time. Nearly got a bit of a fail over here. We're going to escape this way. Bring down those spears for me. That'd be lovely. And you guys go back to normal shot because you're not trying to take out their general no more. No more, no more. Over here. Yep, that's it. You pull the spears over here for me. These guys have disappeared in the trees. Just take these guys out. God's done you a favour. We've lost 400 men so far, but that's okay. And I've pushed up with my spears because I want to draw their spears into my spears because I can't engage the spears head on. I need to flank. These guys have routed. Awesome. Just hit the next lot. Bows! Let's go, let's go, let's go, bows. Alright, well that's happening. You guys should be able to flank this lot over here. You're still fresh. You guys are shaken and are exhausted, but you guys are fine. Because I've not spammed the run button so much with you guys. I'm going to see if I can get a cheeky charge in here. Broken those guys. No, we're not going to be able to do that there. Get the bows on them again. We got a good charge in here. Nice. Another charge. That's them broken. Charge after them, and I don't want any of them coming back, so I will chase these guys to the end of the earth. I don't want them leaving an army behind me. Okay, all of you guys, no more firing at will. No more skirmish mode. Just charge. Ka-charge. No more skirmish mode. How many of them are left over here? Well, that's quite a fair few. Fast forward mode. Fast forward mode. Fast forward mode. Looks like one of them left. That's fine. How many are left over here? 12. Small cavalry unit over here. You guys charging here. There's loads of them. It's full Germanic axe band over here. Charge him. Make him dead. Germanic levy. They're dead. Nice. Ah, see how many are left. Zero, but that's because they've all routed. I wish they'd change that so it's actually men killed rather than count, because it's often quite deceptive because you'll think you've killed lots of the enemy, but in fact you've just made them rout. And actually it's more important sometimes to know when they've gone completely. What have they got behind us? Well, not many of them. And how many of these guys? One. There we go, the rest are dead. End battle. Decisive victory. Could have gone a lot worse. But, I think we did okay. And for me, this is insanely good, because I'm awful with cavalry. And again, some of you are going to be like, why are you playing as the Hunzen? That's what was voted for on my faction vote. And the thing is, the only way I'm going to get better with these guys, with horse factions, is if I actually play them. And this has given me the chance to do that. So I really do appreciate that. We killed the whole force, and I'm going to replenish. Take on warriors. We've done really well with that. So we are going to have to probably encamp to replenish our force a little bit so that we can take on the Vandals. But we can still hinder them all the way, so that's okay. Yanthians, I'm now going to obviously want to flee from those guys that have just moved on my army, and I'm going to go attack their settlement. But I don't have any onagers, so I'm actually having to wait a turn while I build some stuff. Which is not going to be so good, because I could have that other army catching up with me. So I'm going to have to see what the situation is with that. I may have to turn and face that other army first. Hostile agent activity. It failed. Good. How can I help? Ruined provisions, though. That was successful on these guys. Enemy killed in battle. Yeah, we killed them. Illegitimate birth. Oh, yay. The swordsmith. Okay. So, yes, I've had my provisions ruined. We're going to form up here. He can move to there. Keep moving through all these lands. I'm not giving up on the west just yet. Where have those guys gone? Don't like the fact that I can't see those guys. The other army, let's go over here. Are they still over there? Yeah, they're down here. Oh, they left a smaller force. Have they lost some men? I'm not sure. Anyway, we've got the swordsmith. Skilled craftsman has been captured by outriders. He claims the ability to make swords with the deadly curved blades of the east. What should we do with him? Enslave him. Let us see what the stranger has to offer. Kill him. Free man. Then one check bound and chained. We're the Huns. We're going to enslave him. What do you want? Right. Vandals. He can only move to there. Maybe I should try and take out that agent, actually. How can I help? For a turn. Because they're just trying to. I'll give it one go. Oh, successful. But he did not escape unscathed, so he's been wounded. Awesome, and I've leveled up. Shahawit, and I want to go down to. I've already got ruined stores. Ruined food stores. Ruined provisions is what I want. And for that, I need that and that. So then I can get that next time. Cool. Right, so my army now needs to move. Where's the best place for us to move? They come up there. Let's just move back a little bit. Because now they. Yep, okay, that'll do. So we're going to encamp to replenish. We're going to go for integrity and raiding income, battle movement speed for cavalry. I think we go for raiding income, and then I should definitely be raiding. Integrity when encamped, integrity army recruitment capacity, that'd be very useful actually going for that. So rather than boosting that straight away, I'm going to go through here so that next time we get a tradition upgrade, we can get the Royal Host, so we can get improved. We can just build loot units a lot faster. We want to go for Scourge of the World as well. So with these guys, we need... Oh, no, I had to move, so I had to cancel the Akatsari Raiders. So we'll try and build some of them up for two turns. If I can slow these guys down for a bit, then maybe... We'll be okay. Right, here, we don't have any means of, going for them there. Taking the settlement. Unless we captured that onager, but we didn't capture the other army, so... They can definitely catch me. Let's go this way. They do not have an army here. Ah, and I'm going to be able to take it out so easy, because it's just a garrison, so that's cool. Right, in that case, I can take one turn for battering rams. I probably will auto-resolve this one because it's going to be such a, hopefully, easy victory for us. So we're going to go after them. We won't get a chance to subjugate them because they've also got land over here, so we're just going to keep on pushing through. I'm hoping that was their main army that they sent over toward me. So we'll keep fleeing from these guys while we try and just burn this way. So I know that was a good suggestion to go east, and I think so, but I think we've got to take the opportunities that we get, which is pushing over here. Then we'll have to hit the Bastarnians over here, and then we can get to the Gepids. So if we can... Hold down here. I'm not going to piss these guys off just yet. I know they're probably going to declare war. I'm going to get down here if I can. So I'm going to start bringing my tribes back this way. So we will abandon the eastern plans. Yeah, that's where we could flee to if we need to, but I think we've got the opportunity. And actually, it's not been the worst thing to have these guys chase us, because hopefully it means that these are their main armies, which means that there's not got too much defending over here. So I'm hoping we can descend down here, and then we can start hitting Eastern Roman Empire, which should be ripe for... raising and subjugation of any tribes that we find there. So we've got to take out the Vandals as well. But I think if we can take them out, then we can turn around on them and hit them. That's my plan. Let's see if that works. Let's give it an end turn and find out what is going to happen. I'm excited now. Excited to see what's going to happen. Now I should also say apologies that I haven't got my first impressions video out yet. I haven't had time. I've had time, but it's either make the first impressions video or make the Let's Plays. And right now I'm focusing on the Let's Plays. I'm going to have some more time next Tuesday, which is, I'm just trying to work out the date in my head. What even is the date today? Okay, they're attacking me there. Ah, they fooled me. They fooled me into thinking they were alone. Here they come. I'm going to try and retreat, but if they chase me with both armies, then obviously I'm going to have to fight this one. I'm going to have to try and pull off another victory out my arse. Spears, we'll try and hold them up with them. I have plenty of melee cav. We defeated an army of this sword size last time. It's that onager, but we'll go for it. Here we go. Let me just check the date. What is it? It's the 21st day, so 22nd, 23rd, 24th, yeah. So expect the first impressions video now out to be on the 24th. Just because I've essentially got a free day then, so I'm going to sit down and get that first impressions done out. So within that first impressions, you'll see me and hear me critiquing Attila, things I like, things I don't like, things I'd like to see improved, and kind of where I see, you know, what CA have done so far in the series up to now, kind of what they could do to improve. Now, this I hate. Well, forest battles are okay. If I push, I'm going to be able to hide a lot of my cavalry flanking, which is going to be good. But what I'm actually tempted to do is do this and get the enemies then to stream on through, go past my cavalry, and then I'll flank them. Actually, probably don't need to go so far back. But then they'll have to come out of the woods to reach me here. Shaman's here to tell, I'm actually going to group my cavalry into lots of little groups this turn. This time, I'm going to put them straight into the forest and then get them walking slowly so that the AI hopefully doesn't spot them. These guys can be deployed, the guerrilla troops, they can be deployed outside the normal deployment range. So these guys are going to start off hidden. And in fact, I'm going to start them off over here. Having said that, I don't want them starting too far away. Don't know where their reinforcement's going to come in from, so that could change, obviously, all of this. Lancers, we've got there. So we'll get these guys. So we've got two. Actually, no, we could do this differently. Three, take that one in, because that unit's on its own. Right, so we're going to pop... These guys can already hide in the wood down here. Those guys are going to go straight into the woods there. And my horse archers... Now, they could stay hidden, but actually, I don't see much point in keeping them hidden. I'm going to keep them hit well. I want the enemy to actually come down this way so that the trees can provide more cover for my army sweeping in behind, so I'm actually going to... That said, I'm going to deploy my forces down here. So the AI has to come down to me, and I can push out with my cavalry early on. He hopes. So these guys need to be together. They can go straight into the woods here. Forward, and then we'll move them up. The reinforcement's coming in from up here. That's fine. If anything, we should probably try and push on these guys sooner rather than later, just because they're going to get a crap ton of reinforcements. That's a full army. That said, though, I'm probably not going to get that luxury, because I don't think I can move my men there in time. I'm going to run with these guys. We'll sort that out. Meanwhile, I'm going to pull these guys to here. Get them walking. Pull these guys to here. Are all of you guys hidden? Please say you are. Oh, yes. Okay, I've got an opportunity to take out their Onager. Pretty sure. Yeah, I want to pull these guys over this way and be suspecting my troops over here. We'll skirmish them like crazy and draw them down towards my spears here. That means that this forest gives cover for my men to come all the way around behind, hopefully unnoticed until it's too late. The enemy will be deployed around about here. We smash into them from the flanks and the sides. The major threat I see from them is the Onager. I want to take that out soon. So that's what I'm gonna do there. Yeah, and I'm just pulling these two, well, these three units of cavalry, four units of cavalry, rather. They can actually run while being hidden, because it's just such dense forest, which is good. So I'm going to get them into position. These guys are unseen, which is good. So I'm going to wait until the AI pushes past me. So I'm going to hit things onto fast forward. I'm not going to skirmish them just yet, because I know they've got slingers and hurlers, and I don't want them to take down my cab, because they're going to be very important for whittling down some of that infantry later. So the spears are forming up over there. What I'm actually going to do with this slot is pull them back, because I don't want the AI holding up here too much. I want them coming toward me. And they're starting to now. They've reassessed things. Again, I shouldn't... Maybe I should have charged in earlier to get their Onager, because it's now quite tight towards their army. But that's fine. If it's left at the back, I will sacrifice potentially these guys to go in and take them out. They've got pikes back here. That's fine. Checking... All these guys are unseen still, which they are, so that's fine. I'm going to let them push towards my line. That is not a problem. That's it. Come on. Come at me, bruh. I just got to check these guys aren't going to be spotted. No, I don't think they're passing way out of our range, so that's all good. So they're going to come towards us here. I'm going to flank up with these guys here, because I want to, again, put some kind of pressure and notion into my force that that's where I want them. Now, these guys are going to go here, and they're going to get hit by skirmishers early on. I'm running them here, because I'm going to put them into shield screen as well. Because that helps them out a fair amount. Now, they're all coming through staggered a little bit, which is good. I'm going to try and make my move on that Onager. I know they've still got some cavalry down here. But I'm going to run through the trees. I should be covered. Yeah, they're still unseen. So we should, as those guys break through the trees, be able to hit them. Skirmish mode on these guys. Start hitting them here. I know I need to take out the skirmishers, but I need to wait for them to stop before I can turn on them. Walking with these guys. We're going to try and take out their general with a charge. But we've got to watch out for that unit of carry. Right, I'm going to go for those guys there. I'm making my move. That's it. Skirmish to Germanic Levy. Shield screen. Now, I know they're hitting me, so I've just got to survive for a few turns. Whittle these guys down. Whittle their infantry down. We're charging in like so there. Pop out.
We've revealed their deception.
Pop out. Time to pop out and say hi. Charge into these guys. Go straight for their general, into their cavalry, into here, into here, general into here, these guys into here. Take those guys out there. Push them back spears. Charge into these guys. Horse archers out this way. Keep going, keep going, keep going. You guys charge this way. You guys charge back on the swords. The Sporan warriors. General charge in here. Help out my men. We're breaking them anyway, but that's okay. Hit them pretty hard with that charge. Right, now abandon them there. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to... They're trying to pull through a load of them. He's just smashing them. Keep hitting their guys there. Keep hitting this lot. Spears, push them back. Lancers charge into their flanks. You guys charge this lot. You guys charge into their skirmishers. General charge into their skirmishers. Cavalry, breakaway go this way, but then we're going to recharge them all. Right, hit their mounted bows over here. Turn back on them in a second. Oh, we just shattered them there with lancers. Nice. You guys push this way. You guys hold this way. Ah, damn, I got caught over here. Horse archers over here. Hit this lot. Charge into this. These guys, break them. Charge into these guys here, break them. Charge into these guys here, break them. Horse archers, get yourselves down here. Hit those guys there. Cavalry, charge into the swords and break them.
Black tidings. The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing.
I think I just lost my general. Because I got wrecked by javelins. Damn it. Yes, I did just lose my general. Ah, cock it. Because I was focusing on the bit down there. Take out their general, though. We've managed to do it down here. Pretty much. I've lost a unit of lancers somewhere in all this. Hit these guys here. Hit these guys. I shouldn't have taken this cavalry so far away, because they're now exhausted because I've run them so far. Nice. Break him. It's kind of that one. You guys flanking around this way. With their general gone, we should have them. Try and take out those Gothic pikes. No, we've got this, we've got this. Tell these guys, we've got to take out these horse archers over here, though. So actually, I'm going to bring my horse archers up here to take them out. The cavalry, leave their general's unit now, because otherwise we're just going to waste men on them. Bobo's up there. Bobo's. For Tengri. Go, go, go. How many have we lost? Yeah, we've lost well over half.
The men are broken and are fleeing.
Yeah, we've got to be careful, because these brigands are powerful. No, they're gonna defeat me here. Ah, they've rallied. I thought killing their general would do it. Some of these guys.
The enemy outnumbers us. Our men flee the field. The men's resolve is failing.
Yep, it's gonna go. Ah! Damn it! Cavalry, in you go. Didn't manage my forces fast enough. No, they've gone. They've gone. These guys are wavering. Damn. A valiant defeat. Yeah, fortunately I lost my general. No! Seas of Doom. Valiant defeat, so we lost that many. They lost, yeah, 2/3 of their army. I shouldn't have gone in. That was a mistake. Got lured in for a trap. Those guys got 431 kills, those lancers. And I left lancers in for way too long. Smash and grab attacks didn't work. I assume we lose the whole horde. We lose the whole army, do we? I'm not sure. Because we have no general, we'll recruit a new general into that horde. No, they're going to attack us again. And I cannot withdraw. But I am going to fight this one again to see if I can just, again, hit and run them a little bit with some of the weak forces I've got left. The weak, weakened cavalry forces. We should be able to, we can take out that first army. Let's claim it. Let's get rid of their general. And horse archers. Yeah, right. Let's try and do this. I'm going to march towards them and sort of meet them. I've got a general that's been placed in my spears. So that'll do. These guys together. Skirmish. And these guys, group two. This flank. Yeah, their reinforcements coming. And the reason why I'm running my men right now is because I want to get in and hit these guys before their reinforcements get in. So I'm pushing. Should probably march forward quickly with them. They're going to get tired. Just walk them that last little bit. Let's take out their general. Go a heavy shot. I can't really do much charging with my cav here because they're coming downhill. So in that case, we're going to actually have to form up here and draw them down. But if I can take out their general, that'll make that first force a bit more malleable. I hope. Walk them back there. They're fresh again. Take down their general. Come on. Take these guys off skirmish mode. I want to make sure they try and get him. Damn, that's a horde down. We did not need a horde down. That's all of their buildings gone as well, which are vital. Very, very vital to the survival of my faction. Heavy shot's not doing too well. Let's go to normal shot and just see if that'll work. Okay, but you know what? They're giving me a chance to charge them in the back. I get it, I'm going to take it. No, they're charging with cavalry, charging with bow cav. I'm not going to charge those swords, I'm just going to pull these units over here. I see you guys trying to take them out that way. These guys in loose formation. Back on skirmish mode, guys. We need to take out their bows if we can. But uphill battle. I don't see this going too well. No, I'm getting.
Our advantage has been lost.
Oh, I thought I put them in skirmish mode.
The men are broken and are fleeing.
No, flank, 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 flank. Run away, run away. Run away? Am I Jonathan Woss now? No, they're gonna fire on me and do a lot of damage. Hit them, hit them, hit them, hit them, hit them. I can't stay in here for long because they're charging. Run away, run away, run away. Charge and break these guys, come on. Yay, we got them. Charge away into these guys. Small victories. Kill the spears. The swords, rather. I can't do it. Too many. They've just broken there, though. Not going to have any cavalry left. This is a dead horde. Charge the infantry in the back. No, he broke. Five lancers. If you don't break before this charge, that would be fantastic. Because I could do with that being really good right now because they're tier 2 infantry. Yep, there we go. Means we can't withdraw anymore. I'd withdraw my men, but we can't flee any further. No, they're breaking me there. Off skirmish mode. Fire at these guys. Come on. Take down the Gothic warband. No, that's me gone. Oh, damn, a decisive defeat. Ah, rat snacks. Rat snacks. That's just watch my economy go. Those are all those buildings gone. Okay, so we've had a setback there. I still think we can push west. I'm just going to need to get another horde up super fast. And that costs our existing hordes to build a new horde in terms of growth, which is actually really, really bad for us because I can't quickly... It's not a case of just quickly building up. Oh, build up another horde, yeah. I've got to have enough growth for, like, population surplus to do it. Killed in battle. Swordsmith military training. Okay, cool. Who died then? Oh, it was this guy. It was his son. So that's my factionaire gone. Damn. Just lost my factionaire. Who be my factionaire? I've not actually got one. Not got a factionaire now. Right, Munzuk. Declare heir. You're now my heir. Well done. Right, you have an army. Yeah, that's the only two hordes remaining. Damn, damn, damn. Right, I need these guys first of all. Yeah, our economy's gone down by like a grand at least. Gather intelligence? No, thank you. We're going to misdirect them, hopefully. Please be successful. Ah!
I am the knife in the gut.
And I'm going to take attrition if I try and move these guys. We... I'm going to... They are trying to go for me, but you know what? I might just let them come for me. Or I could push out and hit them now. They've got a lot of cavalry, and it's those dogs I'm worried about. That may well be a question for the War Council for next time, but we'll see. I don't think so, because we're going to attack now. And I'm going to go for an auto-resolve. I'm going to go aggressive. Not bad. We only get the opportunity to sack or raise. I'm going to sack. And then I'm going to raise, because they can still use this as a stronghold against me. But we've raised them. We've sacked them. I will now raise you. That does hurt our integrity a little bit. It does hurt the fertility, but Huns don't care. We're going to go and hit them. We're going to keep pushing against them here now. And hope.
Sit. Share my fire. I don't care how tired you are.
I have to hope that we can take it down. Unfortunately, we're going to take attrition this turn. Because of this agent lowering our... No, it's not. Because we actually attacked. Because it's winter. That one there. Royal Yurt Builder. I think we probably need to go for some better units. When can we get like better cav upgrades? Raiders from... Right, so we need to go for that. That's also ammunition. That's unit experience. Oh, that's mounted bows. Replaces step bows. That's 9 turns. That's 9. That's not 3 and 9, rather. I think mounted warband. Actually, I'm going to... Replaces step-mounted tribespeople. Superior cavalry. Yeah, you know what? We're going to have superior cavalry. Okay. Still, we're in the doo-doo. Certainly cannot raise one, although it's only going to cost 6. Surplus. Great. We've only got 2 surplus here, so we're going to have to camp for a few turns. The thing is, if we move, we will take attrition. So I'm going to sit here and let them come to us, and then we'll have to fight it. Hopefully we can defeat them. These guys, the Grim Awakening, well, they were a Grim Awakening. They've certainly pounded us. I need to get another one there, but at least we've carved a little bit of a path towards them. So we can subjugate them when we take out their last settlement here. That'll be good. Need to subjugate some people. These guys up here, where are you guys? They do not like me. That's... Someone didn't declare war on me. That's okay. we need to get down here to help take out the Gepids. Ostrogoths are over here. All I'm hoping is that during this time, they've had just as much a horrible, tough time that I've had. Probably not. Probably it's just me cocking it up. But let's go for this. No, we're not going to go for this battle. We're letting them attack us. So, it's end turn. Unassigned skill. Munzuk. Okay, yes, because you just took that settlement. I need staff, basically, if anything, to increase our growth. Do we get anything to increase growth? I really... hold growth. There we go. An overlord. Not easy to get that one. Nothing over here. Cavalry commander. Melee attack for cavalry units. That's pretty useful. What we need. Hunter as well. I am going to go for... defending, no, we should be okay. Campaign map movement range, vanguard, yes please. And we can increase the movement range again. Yes, I really do need a boost to that.
Get more in your riches.
No, I'm going to take attrition, but I don't want to exacerbate it. I could get attacked in the flank by that other army. If that's the case, I am royally screwed. Let's end turn. If, for whatever reason, just because we're having a bit of a bad turn of events right now, and obviously my own inability to manage cavalry that effectively. If this campaign ends... Aha, cool. Right, we're going to fight this one as well. This time they have a lot of cavalry, but so do I. It's the dogs I'm worried about. I mean, maybe it would be better to do the old auto-resolve, but... We're going to give it a go. But yes, if I lose this campaign before part 10, then I will try again, and then that will be kind of the final time I try it as the Huns for a while. Maybe I'll need to come back to this once I've gone home and tested, but why do I honestly see this as a repeat almost of the Idrisian Kingdom? Literally just fought my... Oh, God, great. It's up a freaking hill. Oh, they're deploying at top of hill. I'm at bottom. Great. Right, well. That's not going to do me any good. There is forest all the way up here, so I could... I say there's forest. There is sparsely populated trees. We could flank behind. What I'm thinking is... Hold down here. Infantry, nice long line. General, I'm not going to throw you in because you're my high king. Well, my step chieftain. So I'm going to keep you hidden in here for as long as possible. Archers, you're going to form up in front and...
Loose formation. No!
Hopefully tempt the enemy down here. And then we're going to hopefully spring cavalry traps from the flanks onto the unsuspecting enemy. And deeper into the trees, there we go. Get a feeling these guys will be seen first. And I'm going to split up my horse archers so I can flank with them. I'll have them on the flanks as well. And then hopefully just descend on in the middle. I'm keeping my general round hidden in the back just so that he can hopefully not die. But we'll keep him, we'll get him stuck in there when needs be. But they're obviously coming from up the top of the hill. And I got crap loads of bloody war dogs which are going to tear my infantry up. Thankfully, they've only got 2 units of spears. Well, I say that. These guys are technically... The dog handlers technically spears. Spearmen. So, yeah, we're going to have fun. What I'm kind of thinking is we can actually pull these guys into the forest. Get the spears disappearing, just so that we've got a better chance of drawing them in a bit more, so we can flank. Don't know what the AI does when we're all hidden, but we'll find out. Hit fast forward, see what happens. Moving their troops down. I'm actually just going to run my units into position just because I don't want them caught out, and they'll have plenty of time to replenish in a moment. These guys are chasing my deer away. Right. Just going to pull these archers back. I'm going to pull them back and I'm going to have to take them out of loose formation because otherwise they're not going to fit nicely behind my cavalry like so. I can see their general. I want to go for him. Germanic mounted warband. Unfortunately, I don't have enough. They've got a lot of cavalry. This is going to be interesting. This is make or break. Get closer in. Spears pull round. So we're going to go into them here. Got to charge in with my spears.
The enemy has found our concealed units.
Or I'm screwing them over big time. separate these guys. Because they're going to break me here. Yeah. Take out their general. Take out their general. Take out the pooches, actually. Gonna lose some cav here, but I'm hoping we'll make up for this in a moment. To get around here. Pull cavalry back, spears, get involved.
The enemy refuses to admit defeat. They use it as rally.
Sodding war dogs. That's what's killing my men. Turn around, hit these guys. Hit these guys here, hit these guys here, come on. We are starting to get the upper hand on them. War dogs need to die.
The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing.
They're all just trying to hit my general. Turn around, charge and hit their general. You guys hit their cav. Their archers. In we go. That's a charge. Down they go in large, large numbers. General's wavering. There we go. He's gone. Break him. Kill, 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 kill. Mounted warband. Go, 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 go. Horse archers. Chase. Chase. Kill, kill, kill. Kill the vandals. Yes! Chase, kill, spears, in, kill their handlers. Archers keep firing, not that was messy. Whew. Especially with losing all that cav, I'm just hoping some of them weren't absolutely obliterated and we'll rebuild. Ooh, edge of extinction here. Edge of frickin' extinction. Oh, it's a victory, yes. I am just going to chase as many of them as I can. I'm trying to kill as many as possible. Annoyingly, those guys have got away. Kill them all. Glad my faction leader survived, which is good. Their general died. End battle. A close victory, indeed it was. We are going to have to do a lot of rebuilding. We've lost lancers, for sure. We probably lost that unit. We probably lost some bows. Oh, dear. We've got 1,200 remaining. They've got 1,000... 1,000, they've got 152 remaining. And we've held them off. Okay, we just lost the lancers. Well, we're going to replenish. And we're probably going to go and strike them in the spring. I don't know if our recruitment's still going to go on, because if that's the case, we've got the Akatsari raiders, so that'll be okay. So other army, Munzuk, is going to keep pushing, hopefully, unless these guys attack him in the rear. Yes, here we go. Now we can flee, or we can fight this one. I'm going to flee to start. To see if they actually will chase. No, cool, they couldn't catch me. Good. So we probably do need to turn around and hit smash them, unless we try and keep... Because they're now going to catch me. They're going to catch me Whoa, Gepids, you just had your region raised. You were my safety basket down in the west. Maybe the east is looking nice now. Right. I see how things are. That's good.
They made ready for war. The world had fallen into shadow. The earth grew cold, and the wind whispered of death. And I beheld a black horse, and he that sat on him had a pair of scales in his hand. Attila was born. All knelt before him, for they knew he would devour the earth and set on fire the foundations of the mountains. Attila was born from darkness and despair.
Enemy killed in battle, so we just have the cutscene there for Attila is born. Mission issued. We gained loads of money for that. We've got loads of money. I'm just going to have to get a crap load of mercenaries, maybe. They've succeeds. They've declared independent. Okay. They've raised themselves. Why? Gepids. What were you thinking? You've probably been wrecked by the Roxolani, that's why. The Ostrogoths are wandering around here again, which makes me worry about going down there to try and hit them. Are these guys at war with anyone else, or is it just me that's pissed them off? Yep. Yay.
I have little gain in wasting the day.
Leave me alone. I could offer you probably a fair bit of money, but I am not in the best condition right now. Okay, where can they... They can only go to there. So if I go through the forest, they're not going to be able to chase me. Cool. Let's move here. Let's form up so we replenish. We could start building things. Anything that will increase growth. I need growth. Hunnic dismounted warband, that's pretty potent. Anything that increases growth? Nope. If anyone knows if they're a way of increasing growth better than I'm already doing it, then do let me know. These guys are fleeing. I'm going to use my money to try and slow them and harass them, just because it will also build up my my spies ability. About to wrap this part up though, guys. And they cannot run that far. Right, we're going to get out of... Okay. Oh, we did get the Azekati. Not Azekati, Akatsari. Oh, we're going to take attrition going for them. But it's so worth it. Come here. Come here.
Wipe them out.
I will wipe you out. I'm going to aggressively kill you. Goodbye.
Have more orders?
Battle reports, household gained, deaths. Ha, Attila nominated heir. There we go. It's automatic bit of scripting. From his father.
Ready for action.
And I know I'm taking yet more attrition, but I'm... Well, no, rather than going west, let's go down here and then re-encamp ourselves. Replenish ourselves back up. Let's get some more cavalry build. We've got mounted. We're fine for those guys. For horse archers, we need some more troops ourselves. We need melee cav. Unfortunately, we don't actually have... These are mounted warband. Well, actually, it's the brigands that... Let me check my research here. We're going to get upgrade from mounted tribes people. It's the mounted warband that we want. Raiders replace the brigands. How do I get tribes people? Mounted tribes people. There we go. Let's build that. So I'll probably get the other horde to do the same, actually. Although we're going to have to constantly get up and do two turns at a time. In that case, for now, I know it's going to tank my income. Not that I need a huge amount of income. But I could go for more noble Akatsari raiders. You know what? I'm going to wrap things up there and let you guys decide. So let me know what you think I should recruit to finish off this army. We're going to increase horde movement range, and we're going to increase key sacking, because we want to go down to growth. But in order to get that, we need a point in here as well, so we can get that. So point in there, next time he ranks up, then it's in there. Cool. I could have lowered down the movement range, but I think movement range is actually quite important for us now. Actually, doing that stops us being able to get heading towards a new horde. In fact, I'm not going to build that yet. I'm going to let you guys decide, do I try and build, save up and build a new horde first, or do I upgrade my cavalry so I can get more powerful cavalry? Depends what I'm recruiting, I guess. So, let's just have a look at little baby Attila. Yeah, he's over here. Which is weird, because he should be underneath you. You did not give birth to him. There he is. Look, he looks so cute. Not like the end of days, although, to be honest, if I continue playing as the Huns right now, he may not get to start the end of days. We're in a bit of trouble. Anyway, hope you enjoyed this part. Don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe, follow me on Facebook and Twitter, take pride and join the Legion. Thanks for tuning in for this hour special. Feel free to leave a like on this video if you've enjoyed it. Until next time, ciao for now.